Hey girls, so I thought it would be an amazing idea to talk to you about waiting in human design, because there are a couple of energy types, and maybe you already know your energy type, and if you don't, you can go to mybodygraph.com, enter all of your details, and then you will find out about your type. But I hope until now, like so far, you know your type, so you can be on board with me. Anyways, but there are a couple of types that kind of have to wait, and these are projectors, generators, and manifesting generators. We have to wait to do something in order to, yeah, basically make a decision. And for projectors, and I'm a projector myself, it's waiting for an invitation. For generators and manifesting generators, it's more waiting to respond. So they need like an external force or an external stimulus to respond to, and then they can see if they want to make a decision. And of course, the whole decision making process also has to do with your authority, so that's a different thing that I will probably cover in a different video. But I wanted to talk about waiting because I feel like a lot of people have a misconception about waiting, and especially when I found out about human design, I was kind of disappointed or frustrated because I thought that I couldn't do anything. And I thought that waiting would mean that I have to sit around like this little guy here, just chilling out and doing nothing and being unproductive and just like waiting for something to happen. And when you think of waiting for something to happen, it's like you enter victim mode. You're like the victim of the external world doing something, and if nothing happens, you basically can't do anything. And that's definitely not true, and I had to learn that as well. And it was definitely not easy for me because I'm usually such a like doer all of the time, and I love to do things all of the time. I keep myself busy a lot, and I know that it's just my conditioning, so waiting for an invitation is just not something that I'm used to, especially because I want things to happen like yesterday, and it's hard for me to be patient. But I learned the beauty in waiting, and that's what I wanted to share with you as well. So if you are a generator, manifesting generators, or even a projector like I am, I want to invite you actually to wait and to embrace waiting, because there's a gift in waiting. Actually, that's what I found out, because it means that while I wait, I can prepare myself for the perfect situation, if that makes sense. So that's the way I see it now, to really dive deep into the topics I'm interested in, to dive deep into the topics that nourish my soul, to take care of myself, to really focus on things that give me pleasure, basically. And it's a beautiful thing to be able to do that, and it's kind of like not an excuse to do that because you have to do it, but just to know that things will work out better if you act according to your design gives you so much freedom. For me, for example, now I feel less guilty researching stuff or just diving deep into topics, because usually I was the kind of person that would think that I always have to be productive and get like really results, like writing 5 blog posts in advance and doing whatever and reaching out to new audiences and clients and whatever, and asking people if they don't respond to me, if something is up. And I know that now it's a lot easier for me to attract the right people because I don't force something, if that makes sense. And all of my one-on-one clients, to be honest with you, reached out to me without me doing anything. Like, of course, they probably have seen me before doing all of this stuff here on social media, and they've known me from other people. I got recommended to them, whatever. And then they watched me, and then they just had this feeling of, I need to reach out to her because I want to work with her, and she's in the right energy, and our energies attracted each other. And then I got the invitation from that person, and then I knew that this person was ready for me. And of course, it's still up to me to listen to my authority if I actually want to let this person into my life. And that's something I have to practice and learn a lot more, because I have self-projected authority. That means that I have to talk through a lot of things. So I have to talk through options basically to make a decision. And sometimes other people can tell me if my voice sounds a little off or if something sounds not right, or I can listen to my own voice and see if it's something that is meant for me or not. It's strange to say, but sometimes I really notice that my voice is not clear and then it's probably a little bit off and stuff. So that's just my authority. Of when you have a different authority, you don't have to listen to this. But it's so interesting how all of that plays in together. And with this live video, I guess I just wanted to hold the space for waiting, because waiting is such a beautiful thing. And a lot of people actually told me that they think that I'm the most patient person and I'm always so calm and I'm always like so chill and relaxed. And I think that's the beautiful aura of being a projector, because subconsciously I always have this inside of me that I don't get stressed so easily and I'm just like chill, but internally I'm not always chill. Definitely not. And I still have like the fiery aspect of being a Leo, I guess. But it's a process, but it's still so worth it, because it will cost you so much stress and resistance if you don't act according to your design, and your relationships will be better and you will have the right people in your life and everything just flourishes so much better. And I just wanted to encourage you basically to try out waiting and not just to sit back and wait doing nothing, because the truth is also that no invitation for a projector or no stimulus to respond can occur if you just sit around at your home and do nothing. I mean, where should all of these invitations, where should they come from? So of course no one invited me to do this live, but I just felt called to do it. And sometimes I invite myself to do it because I just feel like it has to get out there. And I have self-projected authority, so of course I talk a lot in my podcast, and it's kind of like I share my stuff, but at the same time it's the things that I do while waiting, and at the same time it's my authority because I talk through stuff. And so that all plays together and is a perfect fit basically for my human design type. But of course there are different strategies for different types and different people. And that's, for example, something I discuss a lot in my one-on-one coachings, because it's so interesting to build your business around your energetic blueprint, because it's so essential for you to not burn out, to be fulfilled, but to really find what gives you pleasure and how you can be sustainable in your business and have the right energy all of the time and serve your people right, because no one benefits from you being depleted and being like miserable all the time. And you know, protecting your energy is one of my highest values, so of course human design has to play in with that. And I hope that this encouraged you to wait more and to not be afraid of waiting, because it's beautiful. So share your thoughts with me and maybe share what you do while waiting. I would love to know that. You can always DM me. I highly like officially invite you, because when you are a projector, maybe you need the invitation. So I just go in not projector mode and invite you first. But yeah, I would love to chat with you just because it's so much fun. And we are in this together all the time. So happy waiting.